bitch on, we got bulletproof glass now. Bitch, I turned off, I feel like I want a Grammy. I'm speaking Guapanese, I know he cannot understand. Hey yo, it's your boy Atomic coming at you with another Rogue Company video, and today I'm going to be giving you guys my top 8 tips that'll help you become a better Rogue Company player. We're just gonna go ahead and dive right into it. And just before I start, also, if you guys have any other tips, please leave them in the comment section down below so that we can all help each other get better at this game, as this game is still brand new, still in beta, and we all just have so much more to learn together. So my very first tip to you would be to know who all of the rogues in the game are, know their rogue abilities, as well as know what weapons they carry. This will allow you to gain an advantage against your opponent during an actual game. To give you a few examples, number one, let's talk about Scorch, for instance. She is resistant to fire. That is one of her abilities. So if you know that and somebody tosses an incendiary grenade at you, you can actually stand in it, not take any damage, and probably surprise your opponent because they're thinking that they're going to do a lot of damage, but they actually don't do any at all. Another example would be using Anvil, his huge barricade, to block the bomb site. Whenever you are playing demolition, you want to plant the bomb, put the barricade down, and completely block it from your opponent's field of vision. And a third example would be knowing the different kinds of weapons. Let's say that you see an opponent running at you, you know that they are carrying a shotgun. Scorch carries a shotgun. So if you are a character like Cowboy who has a longer range assault rifle and you see her coming up, you want to go ahead and take a 50-50, because if she has her shotgun out, you are going to be able to easily win that fight. And even if she does have her secondary, it is going to be a pistol, which will not be able to compete with your assault rifle. So there are two ways to quickly learn how to understand what the rogues are, or who the rogues are in this game and what they carry. You can either A, grind out those YouTube character guide videos, or the more fun way is to hop into games and use the different rogues yourself. I would rather go with number two. It's a lot more fun. You'll be able to enjoy the game and learn all of these things. Moving on to my third tip, we are now going to start talking about the different gameplay mechanics. And this third tip here is to make sure you have good crosshair placement. So if you ever came from a game like CSGO or Valorant, you know that crosshair placement is very important. In this game, getting that headshot damage off actually does so much damage. It'll help you turn fights quickly, even if they got the first shots off. Or if you got the first shots off, you can easily melt your opponents without taking a lot of damage, which will be very good for you and your team overall. So whenever you are walking around a corner, make sure you always have your crosshair aimed at head level, and you'll be able to get so many more kills really quickly. My next tip is to play this game as if you are playing a tactical shooter. This game is very objective based. The two game modes that are currently out are Demolition and Strikeout. In Demolition, you have two bomb sites. You're either attacking or defending the bomb. And in Strikeout, there is a main objective on the map. You want to try and get to it and hold control over it. This is not Call of Duty Team Deathmatch. And even in Call of Duty game modes like Domination, where there are objectives, you can get away with just running around the map and gunning everyone down. But you want to make sure you play the game tactically. Use the right and left hand peeks. You can shoulder swap in this game really well. Make sure you are holding down the site. Make sure you play together as a team. Don't try and go solo push. You're most likely not going to end up even 1v2ing, talking of 1v4ing a team. So play together as a team and use the character abilities to set up pushes, throw in the grenades, and you will do a much better job than trying to play this game trying to be the hero. Another very important tip in this game is to listen for the audio cues. Rogue footsteps in this game are incredibly loud. Whenever someone's sprinting across the map, you can literally hear them from such a long distance. This will allow you to position yourself well, line up the right hand or left hand peek, and just mow them down as soon as you see them. Even if they are walking, you can still literally hear that very, very loudly, unless they have the ability, which will pretty much put their footsteps away whenever they are walking, or unless they are crouching, which means that when you're on the aggression, if you're doing like a flank for your team, make sure you're crouching whenever you get near the enemy team so that they cannot hear you rolling up to them. You'll be able to catch them by surprise. If not, they're just gonna see you coming every single time and mow you down. My next tip is to pick up other guns and ammunition that you find on the map. This is actually very, very helpful because most of the characters in the game, you'll have like a primary weapon and you'll have that secondary. The secondary isn't the greatest thing in the world. It can still pick up a lot of kills, but you want to make sure you're using that primary weapon. So whenever you run across somebody, you kill them for the first time in the game, switch to your secondary, pick up their offensive weapon, and now you'll be able to have a more versatile loadout. Let's say your character, for instance, has a shotgun. If you kill someone like Cowboy who has an AR and you pick it up, now you have a long range gun and a close range gun, and vice versa as well. If your character has a sniper, you snipe someone down. If you run up to them and pick up their SMG,
now you have a sniper and an SMG. It's just a very good idea to make sure that you use these opponent's weapons to your advantage whenever you're playing this game. My next tip is to make sure that you use the roll feature in this game. It's actually very effective, mainly because a lot of the guns in this game have very small clips, and in addition to that, they have a very fast fire rate. So whenever your opponent starts spraying at you, if you're just getting melted down and you pop a roll to the side, chances are they're going to miss a lot more shots and end up having to reload, giving you a chance to mow them down with your gun. Me personally, whenever I'm in a fight, the only time that I use the roll feature is when I'm playing close to the wall tactically. If I start getting sprayed, I'll dive roll to the side so that I'm behind cover. Or if someone catches me lacking out in the open, I'll try to like 180, and as I'm 180ing, I'll roll, and they'll usually be out of ammo. They won't be able to kill me quickly enough, and then I'll get my chance to kill the opponent. And my last tip of the video, this one is to just have fun and enjoy the game. I know gaming is taking a weird turn. Usually in the past, whenever we hopped on with the boys, you know, we would all just game, relax, sit back, have a great time, and just enjoy the game that we are playing. Nowadays, it's all about becoming the best in the game, getting to the highest rank as quickly as possible, and games just get very sweaty very fast. So just enjoy the game, play with your friends, have a good laugh, and you'll get better at the game really quickly doing that as well. And then of course, when ranks comes out, it's going to be inevitable. Ranks going to come out. Get into the grind season, get as good at this game as you possibly can, but don't take it out on your friends too badly. If you guys like drop a game and your friend throws a game, don't get too mad at them. You know, just enjoy the game for what it is and keep it to yourself. And overall, just enjoy Rogue Company. I'm actually really happy that this game has come out. I always wanted a tactical shooter, especially to be able to play on a console, and especially for me personally on a Nintendo Switch. So I'm very excited. Once again, guys, leave your other tips and tricks in the comment section down below so that we can all learn this game together. Hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I'll catch you in the next one.